Hi, I'm Rachel Donegan. I am the Howe Library's Emerging Technologies Librarian, and I am here to show you how to make something every week. This is Howe Makers. Hi, everybody, and welcome back to Howe Makers. Today I am in Studio H, and I wanted to share with you a new project that I am really excited about. I recently was able to take a webinar with a teacher named Rob Morrill, and he is really into Tinkercad. And another thing he's really into is Tinkercad Codeblocks. So this is Tinkercad, but instead of dragging in shapes and arranging them, you write block-based code. And then the program puts the code together and makes a shape for you. It's really cool. I wanted to share it with you. I'm a beginner with code blocks for sure, and in general with coding. But I wanted to show you this really cool project. This is something that you can do at home. You can make a free account with Tinkercad. You can send me your file and I will print your project for you. And sometimes there's a small fee depending on how big the project is. Anything under 10 grams is free. So you have nothing to lose. You can send me an STL file and I will print it on the 3D printer. So this is the project that I made right here. And I'm gonna show you how I created this in Codeblocks. And I'm also gonna introduce you to our Ultimaker 3D printer. Okay, so here we are in Tinkercad. And I'm signed into my account. And I'm gonna go over here to Codeblocks. Click on that. And we are going to create a new code block. Okay, so this part, if you've played with Tinkercad, looks probably pretty familiar. This is your work plane here. And these are your blocks that you're going to build a program with right in here. So if you've used Scratch before, this will look kind of familiar. Your blocks are over here, you build your scripts here, and then whatever it is that you're building is gonna show up here. So let's try it out. The first thing we're gonna do is create a variable right here. And we're gonna change the name to rotation degrees. Okay, and then we are going to bring out our repeat. And I'm gonna repeat 12 times, and because I know I'm going to make a snowflake, I'm going to bring out an object. This one here. So you can hear the 3D printer starting up in the back there. So this, when you drag it out, it looks like this, but you can click on this little caret here and you get some more options. So, and if you wanted to make it into a hole, you would click over here, but of course we don't want to do that right now. We can change the color if we want. It doesn't look very snowflakey though. Let's do something snowflakey. So our radius is going to be 35, sides 6. It's going to be sort of a hexagon based 2.0 and 16 steps. And then we're going to move. So what we're doing is we're making one, we're going to move it and then rotate around a pivot point. So this will make sense in a minute. We're gonna make the Y 45. So it's just gonna move it up in the Y direction, 45 millimeters. And then we get to rotate. This is the fun part. So actually, before we do that, let's play the program and see what we have so far. I'm actually gonna take out the repeat block. There we go. So we're just gonna run this part and see what we have so far. So to run the program, you have to click this play button up here. And here you can toggle the speed at which this happens. So we'll go about mid speed and just watch over here on the right to see what happens. There we go. So we created this hexagon and then slid it upward. So we're gonna add some more things to our block here. We're gonna rotate. And we want to rotate around the Z axis because we want this thing here. And you can see the axis right here. There's a green is the Y, red is the X, and blue is the Z axis. It goes up and down in space. And you can think of this as sort of a clothesline. And if you rotate around it, it's like winging things around a clothesline or a tetherball court. So, or tetherball pole in this case. So this is going to rotate around this green pole right there. and we want to rotate it by our rotation degrees. And the pivot, you do have to fill this in. I found out the hard way. I thought you could just leave it blank, but no, you cannot. You must put something in there. And so let me scroll over so you can see this better. 0, 0, 0 just means the very center of our work plane. And then we need to, let's see what happens when we play this program as we have it so far. So I'm gonna clear the work plane and I'm gonna come back here so that we can see it straight on. And I'm going to hit play again. So you can see it's making lots of copies of this hexagon, and they're not rotating yet because we're not changing the rotation. So we're going to do that next. I'm going to stop that and clear the plane, clear the work plane, and we're going to change. Going to change that rotation degree by 30. So be a 30 degree shift every single time. Okay, so next we're going to add this create group, which is just going to meld everything together into a printable unit. So let's see what happens. And so this is just a simple hexagon. And because it's rotating and overlapping, and I'm doing nothing right now, the program is just running, but you can see in the middle, you can see what it's doing. It's kind of scrolling through the different parts of the program. And because I told it to loop 12 times, it's gonna do this 12 times. And then that last little flash was the group. So once it was done repeating 12 times, as you can see up here, it does all this 12 times, then it creates a group. It just welds everything together. So now we can export this. And we can export it as an STL if we just want to print it. We can even export it as an SVG if we want to put it in the laser cutter. Or we can export it as a part, which this is very interesting. If you export it as a part, you can bring it into regular Tinkercad and you can add it to other things that you've made in sort of traditional Tinkercad. So say you made a building in Tinkercad, you could make this be a window in Tinkercad, say, in your house. So that's pretty cool. That's pretty powerful. So we are going to just export it as an STL for now. And that is it. There we go. So we're going to open it with Cura, which actually, let's just go ahead and do that. Oh, one thing I did forget to do. Hold on. Go back. You want to change the name of it. Tinkercad gives your files sort of these goofy names. I'm going to call it Snowflake for video. Then I'll know that this is the Snowflake we made for this video. Hit return. Now we can export STL. And we're going to open it with Cura. So Cura is the slicing software that we use with, actually a lot of people use it. It was created, I believe, for Ultimaker printers, which is what we have, but a lot of people use Cura to slice their models. So you would design something and it is an STL or an OBJ. In our case, we use STLs. And what happens is you bring it into Cura to slice it. So what that does is it takes the STL and converts it to G-code, which is the language that the printer actually understands. The printer actually isn't all that smart. The computer does sort of the work of designing and you do the work of designing, and the printer just extrudes the filament. The printhead goes where you tell it to. So G-code tells the filament or tells the printhead where to go as it's extruding. So it's just basically a big line of X, Y, and Z coordinates. And then the printer, if all goes well, the printer does its thing. All right, there we go. Now our model is in Cura. So we can click on it. We can change the scale. So I did this when I printed mine. I actually made this a little bit smaller. So there we go, just so it doesn't take quite so long to print. And it's right in the middle, which is fine. I can hit Control and then mouse to look at this a little bit more. So, and then we can go over here And we can see the default here is sort of a normal. This is the layer height, which is sort of a standard height. This is infill. And we could change those things down here if we wanted to. These are sort of the settings for infill density, this bigger number. If we made this bigger, our part would be stronger. We can also, if we need support, we don't for this case, but if we need to generate support, we can do that there. And I've been doing a lot of my prints lately with no build plate adhesion, and it's going really well. So I think I'm going to leave that at no build plate adhesion. And then we can just turn that, close that off, and we can slice it. And then the computer has to sort of take the model and actually divide it up, make it into G-code. Okay, so it's going to take exactly 2 hours to print this object. So that's not bad, actually. That is a reasonable amount of time.
There is our design being printed out. Looks like it's got the first couple of layers down pretty successfully. That's usually where things go wrong in a 3D print, is early on when the first layer does not stick to the bed. Let's see if we can get a better view down here. Hard to see what's going on. It smells a little bit like marshmallows. So PLA is a corn-based filament. It's a plastic that's made from corn. It's a bioplastic. So it smells kind of good.
Well, that was pretty fun and pretty cool. I hope that you go ahead and try out Codeblocks for yourself. Maybe you'll make a snowflake like mine. Maybe you'll make something else. And definitely share it with me. Tag on social media with Howe Makers. And one thing I should mention too is these files, with a little bit of modification, and I will maybe do another video and show you exactly how to do that. With a little bit of modification, these can be cut on the laser cutter as well. You just have to export as an SVG instead of an STL, and we can put it on our Glowforge laser cutter right here and print it out that way. So that's another option. All right, enjoy Codeblocks, and I'll see you next time. Bye.